Hello, hello, and welcome back to my channel and to the last day, day 5 of my new beauty room series. As you're watching, the beauty room is totally finished. As I'm filming, it isn't, but as you're watching, it is totally finished and I'm going to take you along. I'm going to show you how my beauty room was looking before. I'm going to show you a little bit of the redecorating process and then I'm going to show you how it is looking right now, how I store all my makeup, because you have seen how I store my palettes, how I store my lippies, how I've stored like my samples and stuff like that, but not every drawer has been shown, where I keep my brushes, my setup. So if you want to know how I am filming this, what I'm using as a setup, then please keep on watching because I think this will be fun. Hey you guys, I am going to start today with this very, very messy room. This is my beauty room at the moment. I am going to, here's where I film. That's usually where you sit, and here is the other softbox, and here's the door. I've already started because I've already have this little box standing there. But what I am going to do is today I'm going to clear out this room. As you can see, I've already packed a lot of stuff. There's also some boxes over there because I'm not done yet. This little, the left one, the bottom is empty, the bottom drawer of that one is empty, but the rest is still full of stuff. This one is still full of makeup stuff. You can see my brushes, there's all sort of unorganized, like filming equipment, everything. So I am going to, today I'm going to just clear out this room basically. And what I want to do, there's some baking stuff, this is my background, it's a bit messy right now. This is my dried up bouquet for my wedding. So if you were wondering what that is, these are hanging here. What I'm going to do, I am going to paint this wall. This wall is going to be completely white. It's now a type of off-white sort of thing. It's very, yeah, I don't know. I don't really like the color. It doesn't really show up nice on my film. So I'm going to paint this wall white, and then this wall is going to be wallpaper, and I think I'm going to use wallpaper by Van Gogh, the Blossom one. But this is where I'm going to film, so you will see the white background, the white wall as a background, and I'm probably going to put up those shelves or hang something up to make it a little bit more cute. But that is what I'm going to do today. I am not going to put the camera up and having me walking around. The reason for that is because if I have to do that, then I won't be able to work quickly because, yeah, it would be in the way. So, yeah. Okay, well, I am almost ready to start painting. If you can see, the ceiling is quite, well, white-ish. And the walls are very yellow, you can see it very well right now. I'm just going to paint. Today I am going to wallpaper this wall, and I'm going to do that with this type of wallpaper. It's just a white, yeah, like correction wallpaper, because I don't know if I can show you the wall. You can see it, the wall isn't really like a smooth surface. There's like little sand grains in there. It was all the rage a few years ago in Holland, and it's coming back, that trend, I think, to have these little textured sand, yeah, like particles in your like in your paint, or at least on your wall. So the wall is very like bubbly, and I've got a wallpaper with the peacocks on there, and I won't be able to get a smooth surface out of that. So I'm going to put that white stuff on first, and then I'm going to let it dry, and then the peacock wallpaper, the definite wallpaper, is going to come up. Thank you. Well, that was a new experience for me. I've never done like a picture of that before, but that was fun. I'm going to show you inside all of the cabinets, inside all of the drawers, everything, because I think that is always like the most fun to do, to snoop into other people's stuff. I'm going to hold the camera in my hand, so I hope I will make you seasick. And I'm going to try and film it like this. Let's start with this one. This is my like really vanity type of cabinet. You see me, hi. I have a little mirror here. I usually always blow dry my hair here because that's easier, but I think I might be doing that over there. But I have to see if that is something I prefer. I think it's nice to stand up and look like this. I have a nice little socket over there so I can plug in my hair dryer. So that is what I do. Here's all my perfume. In the back you see the Perfumado ones. In here I just have some loose odds and ends when it comes to the perfumes I already have. Some testers. Also some testers from Sylvain Delacour, I think you pronounce it. Very nice. In here I have all my jewelry. So I've got my watches up there. Over there are my hoops and some necklaces. And in here I have my earrings and bracelets and stuff like that. It's nothing special. I don't have a lot, but it's all in this small, boom, small little thing. Then top drawer. In here I have all like teeth stuff. I have some acid reflux sometimes, so I keep tablets for those. And I've got some of these little pore masks, pore strips, they're called. I've got some shaving creams, anticonception, very important if you don't want to have children. Then over here I have other like odds and ends, also some toothbrushes, I've got some lenses, I've got some razors, some, I think this is just alcohol for when I have to disinfect stuff or if I have to repress stuff, and some contact lenses. And I won't close, please, just behave. In the next drawer I have all my hair stuff, and as you can see it's quite full, but I mainly use this one, this brush, that's why it's a bit dirty. I have to really, really wash it. And this is my like brush when I blow dry my hair. I do that with the brush and the blow dryer. And underneath I've got like a styling. I think I've got a flattening iron. I have a curl iron. I have another like older blow dryer where this one fits on, this diffuser head. And in here, this very small little tin, I have all my elastic bands for in my hair when I want to wear a ponytail. Then over here I have all my panties. These are swimming suits, and this is just pantyhoses and a little soap to make it smell fresh. In here, odds and ends, you know, like soaps, hand soaps. I've got some sunscreen, body lotion I never use, other creams I never use, Vaseline, you can never have enough Vaseline. Okay, that sounds weird. Then some, you know, what the girls need once a month if you are not of a certain age. And in here I have a lot of these small, what's it called, these are baby wipes. I use these as makeup wipes normally. Then I've got some like moist toilet paper. In here I have my samples. You've seen these boxes like on the first day. In there I keep all my samples that I need to get out of my collection. Then this little cabinet, I have some nice little odds and ends. I really like those paintings. And as you can see, that little iceberg one, it's like half a centimeter lower than the other two. That's annoying because I was very particular about getting them straight, but it's what it is, I think. I really like the horse. The horse I've bought when I moved out of the house. I was 18, so I think I have it almost for 20 years now. And it's just, you know, an IKEA poster, so it's not that interesting. And then these three I bought from an artist at this, we have Swan Markets in Holland, and it's like a market where all types of artists that are not on a regular market come to sell their stuff. And I got those three because I think they're really cute. And the middle one is a red robin, as you can see. And red robins are very special for me and my mom because we always believe that when we see a red robin, it's my grandfather. He passed away when I was 14. He was her dad and he was very fond of birds. So we always see if something important happens or something special happens, we always see red robin. So that is why he's in the middle. And I gave one to my niece when she was born. So she had a little reminder of her great-grandfather. So, and here we just have, like, you've seen this, but this is my Chanel box. There are all samples of perfumes in there. I got this from my sister-in-law. She got some stuff that she wanted, she took out, and then the rest she gave to me. This pretty little box. Then the rose. It's a fake one, of course, but it's like Belle and the Beast type of knot. Then you've got the lamp, you've got the stars. This Real Techniques brush, I wanted to have and then I never use it, but I think it's so pretty because it's so going to see if I can put it in a better light. So now you can see it's such a nice deep blue, so I think it's fun to keep it on display. Don't ask me why, I'm just weird like that. Then some driftwood that reminds me of my wedding. We used this as decoration on my wedding. Then you see AC, that's Anchorage, and P for Peter, and our wedding date that was last year, it's almost been a year. And then two little vases, and this is a very old Dutch cookie jar, and I keep just some odds and ends in there, just stuff I don't want to throw away and don't have place for. Then these cabinets are from IKEA as well. These are called Brimnes, and I use them to store like baking goods, baking pans, stuff like that. I also have two in my kitchen to store, you know, goodies, food, stuff like that. I can show you. It's very messy, but as you can see, there are my baking pans, there are some like sugars, baking goods. If you bake regularly, you will recognize them. I also have some like mixing bowls down there, and over there, there are some more wipes, some like things on the right. Can you see my, the things on the right over there are like book stands. So if you are baking and you want to get the recipe on a stand, on the book, then you can put the book on the stand. Then this cabinet, this is an Alex cabinet, as you can see. It is the, what's it, just the 9 drawer, I think. Yeah, the 9 drawer. And I'm going to show you what is in here. Over here, I got all my hair care. I think it's easier to have them all on the top drawer, just to get, you know, I can get to them easily. I can go through them, but I can just dedicate the video to, you know, going through that. These are part of my skincare. Don't roll around. I hate it when you roll around. More skincare, my sheet masks. You've seen this. I've been organizing them in the first video. Two boxes. Oh, this is makeup, I think. Yes, this is the makeup stuff. You've seen this in the first video as well. I keep my backup makeup, and here I keep my cleaning stuff for my brushes. So you see the mattes. This is like a solid cleaner. This is the Daiso for a puff and sponge. This stuff is great, but I really can't get to that easily in Holland. And this is almost done, so I have to really go and hunt for that one. This is the EcoTools shampoo. I use EcoTools shampoo for my EcoTools brushes because somehow they stay a little bit weird if you use like regular soap. This is the MAC brush cleaner. I really like this one. And the Cinema Secrets. I have a big bottle and a smaller bottle. We are going to see in a hot minute. Then really some odds and ends. I have some mirrors in here. I have some old like Liz Eldridge lipstick package. And I've got some like jewelry boxes. Not very spectacular, but it's there. Then here, this is almost empty. This mirror is going to go on display, but I have to figure out where. So that's why it's lying over here. Then here I've got some lamps. These are the lights that I use in my softboxes. So if we go over my setup, I'm going to show you my softboxes. And here also odds and ends. Then these you've also seen in the previous videos. And here I have all my single shadows and my Morphe. I got some new loose pigments from 5050. They're very cute, so I'm going to film a video with them. This one you are also going to recognize. It's where I keep my single shadows. my face products. You've all seen this before. Then all my highlighters, brushes, stuff like that. You've seen this before as well. All the lippies. I've got some Wayne Goss lippies coming. I'm very excited for that. So I'm really curious to try those. And in here also, odds and ends. I keep my planner in here. I keep like, I'm going to show you underneath. On the bottom you can see these like books. These books I use for photographs. I get them at Sistering and Gren, and they have like these very nice, yeah, what you call it, like backgrounds for photos. You can also use them just to arts and crafts, but I like to use them for this. Then you got my notebook, and up there there's my little scale I use for project planning. These I always keep because if I want to send out makeup, I'm going to send some makeup out to Kate, my friend, for her birthday. So I'm going to keep those so I can send her the makeup stuff safely. Then I also got some cards in here. This is the card from Kate. Some more of this bubble wrap. Also nice. Little like wipes, and over there there are the partition boarding. Then we go to the other side, and this thingy I got from a aunt for my birthday a few years ago. Never used it, and now I thought it would be perfect to store all my brushes and like little toolsies. So I have my hair clips and some lip balm over here. I have my nail polish, I put it over here because if you follow my project pen, you know I never use this. And I put my sponges in here. Then I have like these smaller Q-tips. They're very, very easy and handy when you have to correct stuff like makeup and you have to be very precise. So I keep some Nivea makeup remover next to that. Then you've got like, I have three, and this one is also a sharpener. So I have three sharpeners, and one I use for like lip pencils, so you can see it's a little bit pink around the edges so I can recognize it. And then this one is from MAC, and that's for my usual pencils. And over here I use my palette for foundation and to mix stuff on. I keep some Smint in here. I have a few lash curlers, and I have some tweezers, just a few. And over here are my brushes. I didn't clean them, sorry. But yeah, there they are. I have a few. And over there I have some little like cotton pads. These are the only cotton pads I use. I don't use any cotton pads to remove makeup and stuff like that. I only use these to clean my brushes. And then also over here I have some regular pens just for work. I have my lip liners, eyeliners, then my smaller brushes and my blending brushes. And I have, yeah, I've divided it a little bit. So I have here, I have my blush brushes. I have my highlighting brushes over here. These are foundation brushes, bronzer brushes, and just powder. And I know where everything is. It just looks like very grouped together, but I really know where everything is. And I use these small like cup holders or candle holders from IKEA. I think they're very easy. So you have the smaller ones, or the medium ones. These are the bigger ones, like with the cute little birdies. And you have the small ones. And yeah, I think they're very handy and they're extremely cute. And I think they go well with the theme of the room. I hope it was focusing. I don't think so. Okay, then this is the other side of my desk. Over there is my camera stand, or my pot for my camera. And I use this, it's a flower pot officially, or a flower, no, plant. I don't know, you can put plants in there. It's from IKEA as well. I'm a very big fan of IKEA, as you noticed. And I use that as my little bin. Then I want to go into this drawer, because in the other drawer I keep most of my makeup, and I think it's fun to leave that for the last. Over in here I have my laptops, one for work, one private. In here I've got like all stuff I would need for work, filming. So I have like a box to play some music, scissors, a lighter. This is a phone stand so I can do Zoom meetings or house party meetings. In here, this is from a little tin from Benefit, and I have some like things like cables, my memory cards are in here. So I think that is easy. Then I've got a notebook, two of them apparently. Okay, then I have scissors, also some pens. This is my like backup drive. I don't know what it's called in English, but I can put all the videos I'm done, finished filming and uploaded, I can put there for storage. So that's what I do. And this is my card reader for my laptop, because it doesn't have a card reader. Didn't notice that when I was buying it. So in here I have all like storage stuff, and I have some foundations I want to get rid of. I don't like the fresh wear, so I'm going to give them away. Everything storage wise I can't use at the moment, I keep in here. So I have a lot of these. I was talking about these. I was already telling you about these, but it's like I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those lipstick holders. I will probably use this bigger one on my desk, but as you can see, it is kind of full already. So I have to see if I really want to use it, but I think it's nice to have stuff on your desk, but I have to figure out if I really want to do that, because if you see my other drawers, you can see that I already have a lot of stuff near me as it is. So if I paint like an eyeshadow, I paint this little eyeshadow, and this is the Dandelion blush. I keep the little pens. I like to keep them in here. So if I want to repress anything, which I'm not very good at, then I can put it in there, or I can use those. Then in here I have my nail polishes. And I have nail polish removers. I have some Q-tips. I got my cotton pads, like backup cotton pads. These are like wipes to clean your brushes. And these are the boxes you've seen. I keep my tools in there. I keep like tools I don't use. I usually give them away or to my niece or to like my stepmother or my sister-in-law, anything like that. Whoever wants them, I keep them and I give them away. And then this box at the bottom, it's the Galados box. I keep all my sponges, so I know where everything is. And this is the last one. And in here we keep our like kitchen towels, basically. That was just, you know, you had to see that. That was like, you couldn't miss that. And this is the last cabinet. And this is the cabinet I use the most, because in here I keep all my makeup and stuff. All right, let's go over this quickly. I can also do an in-depth video, but I'm already talking for 20 minutes. So this is going to be long enough as it is. In here I keep my puffs, some small cinema cigarettes. So I refilled this one with the bigger one. And in here I keep my... when I need to clean my brushes, I pour a little bit of this in there. I put the cotton pad in the cap and I wiggle around. In here I have some powders for my brows, mascaras, brow stuff, and setting sprays. And in here I keep my face base. I have the Becca under eye primer, I use these two to scrub my lips, and then I use this to nourish them. I've got some SPF in here so I don't forget to put it on, and some like correction sticks I really like to use. Then in here, and this is I think a very nifty system, in here, you're supposed to be in there. And here I keep all my makeup I want to use as for my Shop My Stash. So if you follow my Shop My Stash, then you recognize the product. And over there I keep everything I have to pan. In here I keep my little cloth I use when I do my makeup. And here are the wipes I use when I do my makeup. And there are some makeup wipes underneath. So if this doesn't work, I pull out the makeup wipes. But usually this is enough. And they're very good for sensitive skin. So I'm glad I have those. And they're way cheaper than buying makeup wipes every time. This you've already seen, but this is what I did with the small palettes. So I have these small palettes. You saw them in this big like a Creole box last time, and I put them in here because I used the box for something else and I'm going to show you later. So yeah, I've got my small higher end and the bigger higher end eyeshadows in here, eyeshadow palettes. Then all my indie is over here. You've seen this in yesterday's video, but okay. and then all my drugstore is over here. Okay, then my windowsill. This is the last thing I'm going to show you before I show you my setup. This box I use for my empties. So as you can see, it's overflowing and I really, really need to film the video. This is that acrylic box I was talking about, and now I use it to put everything, like makeup wise, in that I still have to film with. So I want to make, a video on my rougher brushes. I got some odds and ends when I was done with my no buy, so I want to film a video with that. So I've got the Cover FX blush. I have some new eye primer from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I have the, what's this? This is the mini mascara. Got the Corte Rosa palette. I have the 50/50 makeup. What's it called? The Spring palette. I have the Norvina palette. It's in my video. I will link it up there, up in the cards. And I got the Huda Beauty Mint palette. And I have the Corte Rosa palette. I have to film with this stuff. So you know this stuff is coming up. I have this little basket to put all my pen product in when I want to take a photo. Got this little water. I don't know. It's a gieter in Dutch to water the plants. Up there is a little plant. That one I'm keeping for Kate. I'm going to put all her presents in the Beauty Bay box. And over there is a Look Fantastic box. I keep all my Shop My Stash stuff in when I want to take photos. And then this is in the background. I have a little little plant. I have a new lamp. I thought it would be fun to keep that the light wood theme. So it's white with light wood, and I think that is very nice. I also have this vase full of these little fake flowers. I can use them when I want to take pictures. Then over here I keep some quotes. I think I'm going to use this thing. I'm going to decorate it a little bit differently every time. And then over there, there's a little light because I have some light on the back of me. Then over there in the corner, I have put up my filming schedule. I only put up the videos that I want to upload. They're in red. And then I know when I have to film to make sure that that goes on. And this is the beautiful wallpaper. I am so in love with the wallpaper. It's so cute. Alright, let's talk setup. I have two softboxes, one over here and one over here. That one is not on because the plug is not in. Then I use my ring light, and you see that little pot that there. I put my camera on. Before I did my beauty room, I had this big, I don't know if you can see him in the back, but I had this big like pot where I had my ring light on, and then my camera was in my ring light on that little foot. But because I can't put it at the back of my desk, because the desk has to come just way too far forward, and I would have no space to sit because it's not that wide, I chose to just put the ring light on that small one and then use my other tripod to put my camera on, because I'm a little bit more flexible like that. And then I just take this softbox, pull it a little bit closer, and I don't even think I'm going to do that anymore with these other lights, but usually I would just put it closer. Now I have two softboxes on the side of my face, and I have that ring light. What I think is really important about a ring light is that you choose one that can make, that has the ability to dim, that is something, but also you can switch between cool and warm light, and you also can switch between, I think the lighting is, but yeah, you can switch between a minimum and a maximum, so you can dim it and you can make it brighter. I think that is very important to have in a ring light, because you can adjust your lighting to what you need in the room. These are new. These are from IKEA. I haven't filmed since I have these, and they give like this warmer light. So as you can see the difference very well. You see the colder, the colder softbox over there, then the warmer light from the like lamps next to the mirror. And you can see the cooler toned light from the ring light. So I have to adjust my camera, but I also have to adjust my lighting. So this is the setup I use. It wasn't crazy expensive, to be honest. I think the ring light was like $100 with the pod. Then these were, I think, 35 euros each. And they came with lamps already, but they weren't strong enough. So I got these, as I showed you before. These are a little bit brighter. They're from Bresser. And I think they are, yeah, they're like 55 watts. So that's fine. They're also a little bit bigger. I'm going to go and throw away the boxes when I'm done filming this, because they're big. What I also do is I put my iPad over there, because I have an app and the app is connecting to the camera, and so I can see myself in like a viewfinder type of deal. I don't have a special monitor for that. I don't know if I will get one. I might, but it's working like, no, it's working fine as it is. And next to it, I have my battery charger for my camera. I have two batteries. One came with and one I bought separately. And I think the charger came with, because I bought a kit when I bought my camera. So I have always one full or charging, and I have always one in my camera, because I think it's important to have, like, I don't want to have to stop filming. What I like to do is film like 2 or 3 videos in one day, and you really need a second battery if you do that. But I think it's nice because I can film on the weekends, and when I'm done, I just edit during the week. So that is kind of my schedule: filming during the weekend, editing and uploading during the week. That's easiest for me. Is there something else I want to show you? All right, maybe I can tell you about my camera. And I hope, maybe you should just, yeah, I think the lighting is a little bit better like this. I have a Canon EOS M50. This is a camera, I was researching cameras before I got this. I was watching a lot of Think Media, and they said that this was a very nice camera to start with, because it's quite, it's not necessarily cheap, but it's cheaper than a lot of cameras who can do the same thing. And what is very nice about this camera is that the autofocus is very good. So that is why I chose this one. And I must say, it's very easy to use, and I just use the kit lens, so I haven't bought a new lens for it. I might, because then you can make the blurry background. I can't really do that with this one, because the background is a little bit too close, but with a different lens, I think I will be able to. So that is why I chose this one. And I also invested in a little microphone that is probably making a lot of noise, so I'm sorry. This wasn't very expensive. I think it was under 20 euros. Yes, I think like 16 euros, something like this. And this is the Boya BY-MM1. If I can find the stuff, I will link it down below. But the thing is, I am in Holland. So unless you're from Europe and you're watching this, then maybe you can get this stuff. But otherwise, then no, I don't think you can. So I'm just going to film myself like this. I don't have any makeup on. I'm very casual today. But guys, this was it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked what you saw. Please, if you want to see anything in depth, like other information about my setup, if you want to see more, like, I don't know. Whatever. If you saw something and you think, girl, tell me more, let me know down in the comments. I had so much fun filming this. I'm so glad I'm finally done. I must say, I finished everything yesterday. And when I got in here this morning and I cleaned it, or just, you know, made sure I could film in here, I was a bit like emotional, because I'm so, so glad it's finally done. But guys, I am leaving you hanging literally. So thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, then please give it a thumbs up. And I hope I will see you again. So please subscribe. Bye.